it is our relationships with our family and friends, right? If they're healthy and, you know, and not damaging in any way. So doing a lot of exploring and challenging any negative thought patterns associated with those activities, if there are any. Did that answer your question,
Kate? Yeah, for sure.
Right. So once you have recorded all of your activities, you write your mood for the day, and that allows you to further have an understanding of, you know, how your activities are impacting your thinking and, you know, just sense of being.
I have a question.
Yeah.
So we have a 7-year-old, and he does not like school anymore because it's such a struggle for him. So, like, I can see where this will be at for his numbers. But how do you even go about setting goals with a 7-year-old to help him
Find
out, like, have the depression or the self-loathing and stuff?
Yeah, right.
That is a great
pretty
question.
Hard on himself.
Yeah.
7.
Yeah. Yeah, that's a great question. And you know what? I think you see that more often these days than not. And it's tough, but I do also like working with kids and teens, and so I'm not going to do CBT like I'm presenting it to you like I would with a 7-year-old, with a child, with a teen. Mm-hmm. It would be very different. You know, I like to do a lot of play therapy with my kids, and so I might take a lot of what CBT has to offer, but modify the language, do more hands-on fun activities, and get more relaxed and playful. I would also do a lot of work with the parents and, you know, show them how to work with their kids in a different way. You know, from the CBT perspective, you know, how can you encourage your kids gently? How can you challenge their thoughts in a gentle way? How can you help them practice thinking about things in a different way? You know, and especially when working with younger kids, you know, therapists do benefit from working with the parents more readily.